Welcome back, ladies and gentlemen. So our next session comes from TikTok, McDonald's Japan and TBWA Hakuhodo, and we're going to explore the new marketing models engaging Gen Z and millennial audiences. So in this session, you're not only going to learn from one of the most popular and fastest growing mobile platforms out there, but also discover the most popular content amongst this audience, tried and tested. So let's kick things off. Please welcome to the stage the Creative Director, X Design Center TikTok, Norio Ichikawa, Senior Account Director, TBWA, Hiroaki Wada, and Senior VP and Chief Marketing Officer for McDonald's Japan, Fusako Znaiden.
So, hello. My name is Norio Ichikawa, and I'm the creative director for TikTok Japan. And I'm in a team called X Design Center, which is a creative and strategic unit that helps brands and agency come up with interesting and effective campaign in our platform. And today I'm going to talk to you about the new age of WTF. But before I go deep into this, I want to kind of set the stage a little bit. First, current situation, we're oversaturated. We're oversaturated with so many information, products, service, app. Things are getting kind of hard to figure out which is the right products for you. And even if you look at the data from the last 18 years, there's definitely an increase in global data volume, which is 165 times more than what it was in 2001. And because of this all oversaturation, the traditional model of needs and wants are becoming a little bit irrelevant. And it's starting to get really more difficult to find a creative solution based on these two drivers. And especially when there's an era where you could find your needs and wants quickly based on just the click of a button. So with oversaturation comes oversaturation in advertising. So with that, we want to figure out ways to cut through a clutter. So here at TikTok, we figure out ways to do that, and we want to introduce a new marketing drivers. And that is there's no audio, but sorry about that. But it's called a WTF, and it doesn't really necessarily mean what the fuck, but it just means there's three buckets of content or ideas that we analyze based on all the successful campaign that was created within our platform, and we distilled it into three categories. The W for WTF is wish. And wish is empowering people's desire to make a world a better place and help spread positive messages around the globe. The good example is ALS is Ice Bucket Challenge, which is something that was pretty prevalent in 2014. And the message was serious, which is kind of awareness of the disease. And this campaign actually helped bring more donation to the cause. And within the platform, in our platform, our users tend to care about social causes. They love to share things with friends. If they see something that's something that they really care about, they tend to be the first one to share with their friends. And they're also obviously interested in NPOs, nonprofit organization, and they tend to be the one that will volunteer and donate to the cause. And the work that best exemplify WISH is BPM 100. And this is something we did for TBWA Hakuhodo and Japanese Red Cross Society. And it was based on the objective is to get people in Japan to understand how to do CPR. So what they did was create a dance and a choreography that's based on the inspiration of the heart resuscitation technique, as well as BPM 100, which means 100 beat per minute, which is the equivalent to 100 compression per minute to keep your victims alive. So I'm going to show you what they did. And this is based on a video from the influencers that kind of did a funny version of this. So this is still an ongoing global campaign, and you know the number is going to keep going up, and we're kind of seeing like how far this is going to take us to. So the next letter within WTF for T means is try, to enable people to make an effort to accomplish something new. So the good example of this is the bottle cap challenge that was pretty popular in 2014. It seems kind of easy to do, but in reality, it's really hard. But once you get it, it looked pretty amazing. So we actually did this in our office, and we got it right after, I think, 20 tries. But once we got it, it's pretty amazing. When I popped off, then you gave me just a little. And in terms of try, the try feelings are very prevalent in our user base. So, you know, most of the people in our, the user in our platform embrace change. They welcome new change. And they're also very interested in like new gadgets. And they would try, they like to try something new, which means when they see new challenges and hashtag challenges, they're the first one to jump into it. And also when it comes to, action, they leap before they look, which means they take action before overanalyzing things. So it's kind of a good characteristic to have. And the work that best exemplify try is Chipotle's Lid Flip Challenge. This is kind of like the similar thing where bottle cap challenge seems like an easy thing to do, but it's actually really hard. But that challenge is what makes it kind of interesting. So let me show you how it works. This is the first one is the official video that we launched to get the campaign started.
What's up, guys? I'm doing the Chipotle Lid Flip Challenge. It's this easy. Wow, I can't believe I got that!
So it looks pretty easy, but you'll see the second guy gonna try it over and over again and fail miserably. So this was the campaign in US, and they did really well. It was on a lot of publicity, and even the CMO are really happy with the result. And the last letter for WTF, F stands for fun, and it has to be fun. It has to be fun, it has to be easy to join, but it also has to be fun for people who's actually looking at the challenge. And for the example of this is something that's kind of getting big in TikTok. It's called Whoa Challenge. All you have to do is kind of go with the beat, and when it hits, all you have to do is this. And then you kind of, string those videos together and create an interesting video, like almost like a music video. And we did this in our office, a very conservative space, but once we did it and put it together, it looks pretty amazing.
I'm your girl so fine, but her breath is like, she say she wanna dance, but she don't know how to. Iced out, ooh, looking like a star. Her name is Jenny, ooh, bitch, I know Annie's.
And in terms of the fun, that's also prevalent in our user base. They live for fun, enjoys life, they spend money for fun, to have fun, and they feel like the world is the oyster, which means they're very optimistic and they feel like there's a lot of great things in this world, and their mission is to tackle one of those things one at a time. And for the work that's best exemplified of fun is McDonald's Tiddledy Tune. And the objective is to, you know, get people aware of the new value meal that's coming out in McDonald's. But those of you who've ever been to Japan or in McDonald's, have you guys heard this sound before? That's actually a sound of French fries getting ready. And that sound is actually pretty, you know, what people in Japan really like connects McDonald's with that sound. So what TBWA did is pretty clever. They used that sound and created a dance beat and also use it a fun choreography that people just like kind of went into and just like tried out this this challenge right away. I'm gonna show you the video of the official video that we launched first. And this has been the most popular and most effective campaign that's been done in Japan so far, with 191 million views, with 65,000 post video submission. And now you know what WTF stands for, Wish Try Fun. But aside from this like fun, you know, kind of wordplay, there's actually a serious data to back up that these kind of campaign works. There's a significant uplift in brand value. There's like 65.71% of the people remembers this ad. 44% of the people are heard of this ad. 26.6% of the people associate the brand with this campaign. And 25.1% of the people favors the brand that's on that, favors the brand that was on that challenge. And lastly, 14.4% of the people prefer the brand compared to competitors. And aside, speaking of the Tiroli tune, there's been a pretty interesting data that came out of that campaign. That was a 37.02% of people store visit has been increased, and that's just based on the independent research company. And to break it down, where did those numbers come from in our platform? The video submission, the people who submitted the video are influenced to go to that store more often. Next is just the takeover ad and in-feed ad. And then lastly, people who watch those video submissions are influenced to go to that to the store. And this is a very exciting information and data. And we hope to do more of this research in the future. And also try to look for patterns and work with the brands and agency to replicate this result over and over again. So if you guys ever do think of a new campaign or global campaign, please consider using TikTok or hashtag challenges. And if you guys do think of hashtag challenges, please consider our WTF method. Thank you.
Thank you, Norio. So what the fuck? We started off with no audio.
Yeah.
You ended up giving a great presentation.
Yeah,
so thank you for that. I think it was great, very insightful. Thank you. And I think it's given a good appreciation of how content marketing started to evolve and shift over the years. And now with a room full of marketers and agencies, we all know that creating viral content is not an easy task, and it's not simple. So today, I would like to pick your brains to kind of unveil how good content, viral contents, are made. So I'm going to throw you a couple of questions, and let's start. So the first question is for you, Norio. So with TikTok's unique experience that encourages user participation, how do you see this affecting the way brands speak to the audiences?
Well, our UX is based on discovery and recommendation of the content. And to reach an audience, it's not about, within our platform, it's not about how many followers you have. It's based on how engaging our content is. And it's also about the quality of the content. You got to emphasize on that. And I'm not talking about quality in terms of the production quality. It's about how entertaining it is. And it's no longer about speaking to the audience anymore. It's more about interacting with them, engaging them, and participating, have them to participate in your challenge. and also being culturally relevant. So when it comes to participation, you got to talk about barriers to entry. Is it too easy? Is it too hard? Is the music right? So there's a lot of those like factors. It definitely becomes much harder to do, but the effect is much more it's much more better. And I feel like doing these kind of thing has definitely changed the way we speak to the audience.
Great. I see. So Fusako, now Norio spoke about the importance of engagement, participation, and the cultural relevancy. From your point of view, how important has it been to place McDonald's in the cultural conversations using social media?
Well, I believe that the social network communication has a big role always to build the brand equity and brand perception, relevant brand perception in the consumer's mind. For instance, we always think about how we increase the share of mind or of our brand in consumer's mind. How we are going to do that, we have to target the right audience, what their really insightful insight is going to be, and what could be the story for them to be really relevant. So express that story, I think the SNS is a perfect current media platform to reach them in a very effective way. At the end, the consumer start feeling like, oh, the McDonald's is like brand for me, which is a really the ultimate goal we are aiming to. So that's how I see the SNS media platform at this moment.
Right. And I know placing brands at the heart of cultural insights is not an easy task. And Norio also mentioned in his presentation that the world is oversaturated right now. So my other question for you, Fusako, is can you tell us how experimental is McDonald's is in exploring new platforms?
Well, this internet or mobile phone and social network, the trend is moving very, very fast, right? So you have to have a very sharp sensitivity. What could be the really relevant media platform for the younger kids, for instance, the younger consumers? So we have many examples in the world, and all the marketer has to have the eye on opening what sort of the media vehicle contents or culturally relevant story is going to be really effective to attach the consumer. So that's how we are seeing to develop the contents of the SNS social network media platform contents.
Right. And Norio, essentially, every person who participates with TikTok's hash challenges is a brand advocate. Does this then change the way brands should approach influencer marketing on TikTok?
Yeah, we have to find right people to co-create, to like drive participation and like engagement. And in our industry, I see that, you know, influencers are taking a lead. And in our platform, influencers are becoming creator of music, creator of, you know, dances, creator of like film, graphic design, whatever. You know, gone are the days where, you know, brands are using influencers to, you know, project their message. You know, it's about tapping these creators and harnessing their creativity and create a movement. And a good example of that is in US where they, Lil Nas X, he's a creator of music, and people have been using that for their content and on their challenges, and it just kind of blew up. The music got stuck, and they're like, he was like, he's a top 10, one of the top Billboard artists now. So those kind of things.
Okay. Now for creative agencies like myself, we know that platforms like TikTok fundamentally change the way we approach social campaigns. Mm-hmm. In addition to storytelling, mm-hmm. we now put emphasis on audience participation and user-generated contents. Now, can you share some suggestions on how to create impactful TikTok content with examples?
Sure. Storytelling is still an essential part of creating a good content or a successful campaign. And there has to be a reason why people are doing why we are doing things, and people have to care about the message that we're conveying. But in terms of tactic, you know, simplicity of challenge, setting clear rules, but also leave little room for creativities to happen. And also incorporation of filter, like, you know, brand filters and, you know, facial recognition, features, effect definitely helps lower the barrier and expands the message. And music, catchy music is one of the most important part of that as well. And we recommend BPM of about 100 to, you know, kind of make it interesting. But, you know, it also depends on the brand campaign. And like I said earlier, it's about being easy and, you know, fun to participate. But if you have an emotive campaign, that also has to be fun. You know, the good example is that, you know, BPM 100 and the Ice Bucket Challenge. The message is serious, but it's still fun to do and it's lighthearted. So, you know, but the purpose has to be clear.
Right. So, Fusako, let's talk about the Tirori Tune, the McDonald's campaign. Yeah. Norio mentioned about how to create good contents over TikTok. And it's great that this campaign really showcased one of the greatest, most effective contents on TikTok, with a record breaking of 191 views and 65,000 UGCs. Now that's massive. That's almost 80 to 90% of the whole TikTok base in Japan. Can you talk us through how that campaign came to life and how did it add value to the McDonald's overall communication?
Thank you very much to recognize this campaign thing, but as a starting point, we have mission to build awareness and trial for this very reasonable price, entry price point value meal. And so we are talking about who should be targeting as a target audience. So because it's a price point, probably the high school kids, could be group gathering people, could be the good audience. So you suggested a wonderful creative concept, which is like the fun gathering moment like this is like real treat for us. I think it's a fantastic concept because everybody is feeling that way in the McDonald's, in the restaurant, and all the Japanese people and consumer has that kind of memory, staying, having fun time in the McDonald's restaurant. So let's do that. And before that, the McDonald's campaign, even for this entry price point meal advertising, it was mostly like telling that this is a product we are going to offer and this is a price point. But this campaign has been changed completely, this approach, which worked beautifully, which means that we are showing how young students are having fun in a McDonald's restaurant. That story was really powerful to reach the consumer. So part of this storytelling, what could be the shareable fun doing together in a restaurant, for instance, with a friend sort of content, and then you guys came up with this Tirori tune, like a Tirori, Tirori, Tirori is a very famous song for Japanese consumer. Every single person reminds, oh, fresh French fry is ready for us, right? McDonald's fries, ready for us. So that's a fantastic story. Actually, I have a young daughter, and she was telling me that, why don't you create advertising creative with using this Tirori, Tirori, Tirori? So I was like, yeah, that could be a great idea. And coincidentally, you guys came up with this great, great TikTok contents that worked beautifully.
I think what was powerful was we utilized your existing asset and turned it into a viral content. And that was what people have talked about and had fun about.
Exactly.
McDonald's is serious. They're using that sound to create communication. And that was something that really hit the consumers.
Yeah.
And consumers and had fun.
That is not only in the smartphone world. Actually, I visited many restaurants just after we started this campaign, and many restaurant managers mentioned to me many young students were doing this Tirori Tune dancing in the store. They look really fun, and the store manager, restaurant manager really perceived in that moment. So this is fantastic for the brand. So it's not only in the mobile phone screen, but also the real life, and yeah. it's a great
And not
example.
To mention the store visit rate increased right after.
Right.
Right. Yeah. So that's great. That's very encouraging. Thank you for that. If I were to add one more success factor to this campaign, it would be the partnership that we had between TikTok, McDonald's, and the agency. So thank you for that. I think it was a great campaign. My final question is for you, Fusako. Apparent from today's session, the content marketing ecosystem is changing at the speed of culture. In what way is McDonald's evolving its marketing strategy to remain relevant as a 21st century brand? And please do give the audience some tips and advice.
Well, I think these days, the messages from the older brands, not only from the McDonald's, are getting really borderless. And it comes to much more authentic, eternal, fundamental insight. It's getting more and more stronger in my view. So how we are expressing our brand message or brand value in consumer relevant point of view, not like a manufacturer relevant or brand relevant point of view, it's gonna be very, very essential. And the second point I would suggest is that, for instance, there are many, many promotions and advertising creative are happening in the world. What sort of messages or how to express the messages with what sort of media platform is receiving or is being appreciated by consumer. If you have the smartphone, you can see all the great examples. So as a marketer, even I'm a CMO, I'm doing every day what sort of new things are happening in the world and then being interested in what is going on in the world is going to be very, very important.
Right. Yeah. Thank you, Fusako. I think, yeah, placing brands at the center of culture and embedding the brand into people's daily lives is very essential. I think that was a very valid point and a really strong message. So that was a very informative and insightful session. So thank you, Nori and Fusako. And among the many points that we discussed today, there's one thing that really stood out for me and which sums up the successful partner between McDonald's, TikTok, and TBWA. And that is, I think, having bravery and taking risks. Be brave enough to involve consumers at the center of modern culture. Be brave enough to create what may seem ridiculous at some point, and also be brave enough to trust your business partners, especially in this fast-changing and complex 21st century world. So on that note, we'll leave you something to think about, and that concludes our discussions. So thank you.
Thank you. Don't do the right thing. God knows you'll be tempted. The right thing sounds so good in meetings. It looks fantastic in charts. The right thing soothes racing pulses and settles churning stomachs. Everybody can get on board with the right thing. The right thing is good enough. But good enough is not enough. Don't do it. Don't do the right thing. Avoid it like the plague. So what are you supposed to do? The wrong thing? Of course not. Do the brave thing. The thing that troubles your sleep. The thing with a million unknowns. That seems ridiculous one moment and genius the next. That's the thing you should do. Chase it down. Don't let it go. Do the thing that disrupts, that upends, that doesn't just defy the status quo, but reshapes it forever. You can do that. You have that in you. To do the right thing or not is a choice. To disrupt or not is a choice. Let's do the brave thing.
Thank you very much to our speakers. They're going to head over to the Meetups Lounge to take part in a Meet the Speakers session. So if you've got any questions for them, do head that way. And you can also grab a free Tiger beer in the fridges, both in the Spikes Asia Cafe and the Tiger Bar. Just go and help yourselves.